We had the opportunity to go through your financing partner at Daktronix. And so we've actually financed the board over the next 6 years. We were able to add that to our project at the last minute and get the opportunity to use the board right away. So it worked out for both of us.
Hello, and welcome to the Daktronix Experience Podcast. I'm Justin Oxner here with Matt Anderson. Today, we're talking with Larry Leckenby, Director of Athletics for Catawba College. He's going to tell us about their new video board at their stadium, the financing that made it possible, and what the future holds for their campus. And we're here today with Larry. Larry, how you doing?
I'm doing great. Hope you guys are too.
Oh yeah, we're doing good over here. We're in the Daktronix bunker,
yep,
which is where we hit all the podcasting equipment so we can continue to do this. Could we start by getting a little bit of your background at Catawba College?
Absolutely, absolutely. I've been here, this is my seventh season as director of athletics. Overall, I've got 30 plus years in college athletics. So this is my seventh campus, and my seventh year.
Wow. So seven different campuses. Where did you start out at, and kind of how did you know that this was going to be, you know, the career that you wanted to be in?
Well, actually, I had a little advantage. My father was a small school football coach and athletic director when I grew up. So I've been on campus my whole life, so to speak, and grew up. I tried the real world for about 2 years when I got out of college and was miserable with it. And my dad was still at Lehigh University at the time. So I took the leap to grad school at UMass and got my first job at Boston University back in the 80s. And I've been moving around the country ever since, all at Division I until I came to Catawba College, which is a Division II athletic program.
Okay. And We're here to talk a little bit about the technology and stuff you've got on campus there. Can you tell us about the first LED installation that you had? I believe you had some scores tables to begin with.
Yeah. When I arrived in 2014, we had a lot of need for renovating our facilities. So the first thing we did was renovate our gym, our basketball and volleyball arena. Completely redid that. And we were fortunate enough to put in two LED scorers tables at Press Row, and that was Catawba's first venture into technology at ball games. So we put that in, and gosh, it's 5 years later. We put together this project for the football stadium and ended up with a really, really nice large Daktronix video board.
Nice. And I'm thinking back too, Larry, when you said those scorers tables were kind of your first step into this LED technology, I won't say you got the taste for it and wanted more, but you know, can you think back to that first event you had with those scores tables too, and just kind of the effect that had on everyone?
Yeah, you know, it was, it's been fun putting these projects together for Catawba, but we took a 50-year-old gym and completely renovated it. And we did not put video boards on the walls, but we were able to get two LED Press Row tables, and we hired a young man who was just out of college, graphic design expertise, and he put in, you know, players' headshots and stats and hometowns, and he put in all our advertising. We started corporate advertising with that. And, you know, we did it for men's and women's basketball and volleyball matches, and it was actually a real big hit. You know, people at Catawba who'd never had this type of technology or even a LED board anywhere noticed it, and certainly the student athletes loved it. You know, they love to see their face in lights and some of their stats, only their good stats though. But it was fun, and certainly moms and dads like to see their daughter or son's name in lights and hometowns. And then of course we were able to start a small program in corporate marketing as well. So we got to convince several of the local restaurants and companies in town to get on board from a corporate perspective and advertise with us. And we host a big high school basketball tournament in the winter, and that was a big boost for them as well. So it was a lot of fun, and that morphed into the stadium project this past summer.
I was just going to say, kind of going fast forward a little bit, you know, you go from the scores tables now to a big video display. Maybe Maybe just kind of run us through the beginning of this project, you know, for the football stadium. How did it come about and how did you end up where you are now?
Well, we had a huge need to put in a turf field. All our fields here were grass, and we do have some weather and flooding difficulties. So we played a lot in the mud, so to speak. And I've known, so we started with a field turf project or an AstroTurf project. And I've known Corey Williams for a long time through several of my stops, and got together with Corey, and he was able to put together a project that transformed our old scoreboard into a Daktronics video board in a short amount of time, using the same structure that our scoreboard was on. And your designers came up with a fairly unique board because it's way more rectangular and wider than what you normally see in your stadiums. But we had a need to fit into the existing structure, and Daktronics was great, put it together for us, and we added it to our project for the turf and the sound system. So we actually renovated the stadium with a brand new field, brand new sound system, and then the video board on top of it.
So when you started this project, was that all in the works pre-COVID, and did getting into that time affect the project timeline at all?
You know, that's a great question. It has been pre-COVID. At a small school like Catawba, it takes a while to raise seven figures for an athletic project. And we raised about $1.1 million, and we're putting in the turf field and the sound system. And Corey had put together this great design with your Daktronics designers for the video board. And we weren't going to do it this summer based on finances. And we had the opportunity to go through your financing partner at Daktronics. And so we've actually financed the board over, I believe, the next 6 years. So we were able to add that to our project at the last minute. And we've got money coming in over the next 3 to 5 years. And we get the opportunity to use the board right away. So it worked out for both of us.
Awesome. Yeah. And it's great to hear, you know, that there was something able to help carry it through here too. So you mentioned the financial kind of aspect of it and how we were able to help out with our financing options. Then maybe just talk a little bit about the sponsorship. I mean, you kind of talked about you raised over $1 million with that. So how did it kind of go with that then? Is it going to affect it going forward, knowing that now you have a video board to kind of sell sponsorships on?
Well, you know, we'll take what we did in the gym with the small LED press row tables. And we'll take that concept to the stadium. We play football and men's and women's lacrosse in our stadium. So we'll add the opportunity, I guess, for spots, as the TV people call them. And we've started to collect from our local support from the restaurants and corporations in town. And we've added spots in 20, 30, and 60 seconds. So yeah, it's going to be a new venture for us. Nobody here has done that in the past. So we're kind of flying blind on how to do it. But we did the whole project pre-COVID. And actually, to be honest, COVID was a catalyst when it hit and the school shut down. We had about 4 projects that we were slated to do this summer. And our board of trustees and our president were nice enough to allow us to go ahead with it, since we'd raised the money for it in advance, with the exception of the video board that we ended up financing. And we got off to an early start in April rather than starting May or June. So it was actually a bonus for us. Kept our staff busy all summer while there were no students here. And we did several capital projects and used the funds that we had raised for the last 3 to 4 years.
That's awesome. I always like hearing, you know, talking to different customers now, what are some of those silver linings that they're finding out here during these COVID times about things that can help out with their projects?
Yeah, it's a strange time for all of us, and certainly in college athletics. We haven't played any type of sporting event here since I think March 7th was our last baseball game, I believe, and they shut us down a few days later. And we've postponed everything until all our fall sports have been postponed till the spring. Our goal right now is to start basketball the weekend before Thanksgiving. So the outdoor board literally has only been used twice for the last two Saturdays at football practices. We felt comfortable enough with some of the design entities and a few advertising spots that we went ahead and put them up for the kids at their practices the last two Saturdays when they were in the stadium. And I think it was a big hit. At one point, I think that everybody stopped practicing and turned to look at the board. Not sure the coach was happy with that at the time, but
that's good to hear.
He laughed about it afterwards.
That's good to hear that you did that during a practice so that they get that out of the way. Yeah. So everybody can turn and look at it during a practice instead of during a game when they get there and they're in shock and awe of being on the display, right?
No. So yeah, we've had, I guess two practices, and we actually have a club team in the area who, actually played, last Saturday night, and, our guys fooled around a little bit with it and, threw some local ads, Cheerwine and Food Lion are two, Salisbury corporation. So we've got little ads up for them, and it was kind of fun. So sad that we haven't played any real games, but fun gives us a lot of time since literally we have no experience with the graphics and the background and running a board of this magnitude.
I was going to say another silver lining is that you're able to have many different dress rehearsals, I guess, now, especially from not having experience, like you said, with a video board to now having a big one. Maybe just talk about as you're learning the different things here, how has it been to control the display? Have you tried anything crazy yet, or have you been putting up just live video, or maybe just run me through how your control room is set up?
That's over my head, but the guys that have come, we've got one young man who's in grad school here who's got some experience at a previous school, and then we've contracted with one of our former basketball players who's a graphic designer nearby, and literally they're playing with it. I wouldn't say every day, but when they get a chance, and Jacob's put in the spots. And like I said, he was just fooling around at the club football game last Saturday night. And all of a sudden a Cheerwine advertisement showed up on the board, which was kind of cool. And we're just trying to figure out, it's got all those zones for the scoreboard and for the ads and for the video, and we're trying to figure it out so that we don't mess it up too much and take the scoreboard down and put up a commercial, and we're trying to keep them both up there at the same time. So
there you go. Yeah. It sounds like you have the right people in place to figure all that out, and you're learning as you go. So it'll be interesting. We always say this with somebody who has a video display for the first time, it's always interesting to talk to them a year later too, to see what they've learned and how they've grown with it. You said you had a couple people working on it. Do you know if you plan on having students help with this other than the two people that you've kind of got in charge of it?
Well, that's our goal in the long run. The school is just in the first semester of a sports management grad school. So we have about 15 young people who are in grad school here for the first time. And we're hoping to get some of their interest and expertise in the game operations and video board part of a football game. And if we can work that into the curriculum and from a assistantship type of perspective in the future. We didn't have that opportunity this year, hopefully that will work out. And eventually, I think some of the undergrad students, again, it's not a large school, but I would hope there'd be somebody who's not playing a sport or has major activities who would like to do it. And, either as a sidelight or something they might want to do for a living in the future.
Mm-hmm. I think that's an area we always love to hear about, especially in colleges. And we've heard from some customers in high school, even right when they get a video board, everyone thinks about live video stats and then, sponsorship. It can be a revenue generator, but there's always this curriculum side of things that some people may not think about. Like you're saying, people can get a lot of real world experience so that they can take what this video board is opportunity. The video board has given them. And if they want to keep doing it, they can be a freelancer. They can work in professional sports later on after they graduate. That's awesome.
Yeah. And again, our first experience with Justin, who's from UNC Pembroke, he just worked on their board as an operator during football games as an undergrad. And we're hoping that he'll take the lead and for the next 2 years while he's in grad school, kind of take over the ownership of the board for us and run it and teach some other students how to do it like he was taught when he was an undergrad.
Yeah. So then is, I mean, without getting too much detail, so is the control room that's controlling the video board, is that out there at the stadium, or do you kind of have that, you know, some people have it like in different areas around the campus too. So I didn't know, like, where is the control room at?
It's just a piece of our small press box.
Okay.
Building. The controller will be right on the fourth floor of the building, and the all the toys are hidden away on the second floor somewhere with all the other electronic devices.
Okay. And I'm curious, you said you host multiple events at the stadium, and you held multiple events inside the arena. Does the flexibility that the LED display provides at the stadium, was that a factor in kind of adding that onto this project as well?
Yes. I think our overall goal for the project, one, to put the turf field in, and two, to put the video board in, along with the sound system, was we have the only artificial turf field in the county here in our part of North Carolina.
Okay.
So we're hoping to establish, we host a lot of high school basketball here in the gym, in the renovated gym. I say renovated, it's 4 years old now, 5 years old mm-hmm. this season. But we'd like to establish that type of relationship with some of the county schools for football. And again, we can do the same thing from a marketing perspective with their advertisers and help them out by using the video board. But we can now, again, as you guys know, with an artificial turf field, we can have Friday night football and turn around the next day and not worry about the field's going to be in great shape.
Yep.
The sound system's new and the video board's new, so everything should be in great shape for mm-hmm. multiple events on any given fall weekend.
And I didn't even think about it. Well, now I did, obviously, because I'm bringing it up. But you had mentioned something at the beginning, and now that I was just tying together in my head was, you know, when you got the scores tables at the arena, how cool it was for athletes to see their face in there and see their parents seeing their faces on the scores table. And then now hosting, you know, high school events, there's a recruiting aspect to these kind of things, right? So, I mean, high school students come and see all these different things going on with the LED displays. That's got to help that out a little bit, doesn't it?
Oh, absolutely. I think it's a major boon just to have the recruits walk through the stadium. Again, coaches are smarter than the average person. You know, they'll have the video board on mm-hmm. when the recruits come by. As they walk them across that new artificial turf, and the sound system will be playing some kind of music for pre-practice, et cetera. So yeah, the whole thing ties into recruiting. And again, at a small school like Catawba, it's just important for us to get high school kids to our campus mm-hmm. to see it. And whether they end up playing football or another sport, as long as if we can get them to campus and impress them, maybe we'll have a student in the future.
Right, right. And it sounds like you've got a nice setup there. Everything's kind of new and looking good for those students. And you said you're just renovating everything and it's opening up and you've had a couple practices. What's it feel like to know that going forward, you still have a local service person there from Daktronics to kind of help out if something comes up?
Oh, that's imperative and part of the conversations with the various video board companies. I've worked with Corey over the years on different projects at different schools. And that's a big benefit from the Daktronics perspective, is that there'll be somebody here within a phone call away and can either walk us through the problem or be here in a reasonable amount of time to save us when we've messed up with, in my case, it'd be operator error.
Right. That would be my case too, probably. You didn't have to laugh at me there, man.
No, I was just saying that's one of the first things they did when I started Daktronics as an intern, is they make you go through all these different events and run all the equipment over and over and over again so that you get to that comfortability level so you don't screw up too much. So you kind of mentioned it was a big talking point. I mean, you knew Corey throughout the years, but there's just kind of a question I had too. When you first started talking about this project and the video board, not having a video board previously, was there a lot of work that had to be done to kind of, you know, explain the technical aspect of it or let people know there's more to it than just getting a TV?
I'm not sure that sunk in with my bosses yet. It's a little more difficult than just turn it on and it appears.
Yep. So, right.
I guess in our case, we'd have to go back. I think because of the timing on the board and if you go back, we weren't going to do the board this summer, as I said, based on the original funding proposals. So we all thought we had plenty of time and we'd get the field done and the renovation done, and we put the board in at a later date and we'd have lots of time. I think the board was installed with maybe 3 or 4 days prior to the originally scheduled first home game. And that would have been a lot of fun trying to turn it on. And we probably wouldn't have been able to do the first and 10 for that first game, much less any videos or advertising. So, you know, there, like you said, there's always a silver lining. Hopefully we'll have enough knowledge by the time we get to, I think, March 10th or so is our first home football game. We're going to play 2 home football games in the spring. And about between men's and women's lacrosse, we'll play another 26 games. So we'll have it up and running several times during the spring. And hopefully between now and then, we'll figure out which button is video, which button is replays, which button is scoreboard.
Right.
And you know, somebody mentioned it earlier that not only the kids, but their parents and friends in the stands. I mean, what's more exciting than to see that goal in the cross, you know, replayed 6 times that your son or daughter just made on the field, or that touchdown catch that somebody dives for in the corner of the end zone. And if we can figure it out, we'll replay that a dozen times for them right after the touchdown.
Right. I was going to say, what are you looking forward to most when this is turned on for a live event? But I think you kind of answered that. Is there anything else you're kind of looking to do with this that you're kind of excited about? Or is it what you said?
I'm probably supposed to say the corporate marketing aspect of things, but I do think the replays would be a lot more fun.
Right.
To watch.
Going from no replays to having a replay anytime you need it, that's going to be a big change.
Yeah. And again, for a school like this, just having, think about the stadiums you've been in that don't have video boards and small schools, there's just static signs and it might just say Food Lion or Cheerwine or F&M Bank. Now those guys in the community who work at those companies or run those companies be able to actually see their TV spots run, you know, during a Catawba Lenoir Ryan football game or a lacrosse game. And that's kind of cool too, I think, because it is, we know we're a part of this small community and the school, I think, is a big part of it. And to have those guys show up, you know, our football coach is in the F&M Bank commercials, to be honest. So that's probably the first one we'll throw up there just to embarrass him and his family.
Naturally. Yeah.
That's awesome. Cause I'm thinking, you know, either your sponsorship, the corporate marketing side, going from scores tables to a video board is just, they gotta be really excited about that too, because you're talking about, there's so many other things you can do. You got so much more real estate to use now.
Yeah. And Justin, who I mentioned earlier, coming from Pembroke, said, you can run, these ads and commercials, you know, an hour, 90 minutes before the game and an hour after the game and all through halftime. I said, you couldn't get enough ads to fill the time. So it'll be fun.
Awesome. So we're talking about the projects you're going on, you know, the basketball one and then now football going. Maybe just kind of a good way to help wrap this up. Tell our listeners maybe what's in store for Catawba College here going forward the next year, knowing that anything could change on a week-to-week basis, but kind of what's that crystal ball look like for you?
Well, number one, as you alluded to, number one is to play. Mm-hmm. So our kids, our students and faculty and staff have done a great job with testing and keeping positive tests to a minimum. So school is in session, professors are teaching. We have a hybrid of in-person classes and online classes, but our kids are here on campus. So we're looking forward to being able to play. Basketball will start November 21st at the moment, all things being equal, and they've done a great job. And literally the spring will be unique, as we've alluded to in March. We'll have everybody. We'll have baseball, softball, lacrosse, soccer, football, volleyball, tennis, golf. I'm sure I missed somebody.
Wow. But
that's going to be a lot of games from the end of February through the beginning of April, because that's when we're going to try to put all our fall sports in place. And then we'll finish up with a month or 6 weeks of just the spring sports themselves. But, you know, knock on wood, that's the goal, is to keep everybody healthy and safe and give these kids a chance to play. They've been practicing for the last 2 to 4 weeks. So they're outside and getting back at it. And it'll just be fun to have some competition at the end of the rainbow here. And the boards will be up for lacrosse and football as soon as we can get them in there.
I was just going to say, because I have heard that from colleges too. I'm not sure if you'd say it's bittersweet, but you go from no sports really wanting them, and then just thinking ahead to the spring is you are going to be in sports overload, and you are going to be, you're going to be running around probably everywhere, but you're going to be loving it because sports will be back, right?
Yeah, it'll be your own version of March Madness.
Oh. Absolutely. And that's why the board's got a great warranty on it. So
you're going to use that thing up.
We can use it all the time.
Nice. Well, Larry, I want to thank you for coming on here and sharing your story with us and sharing everything you've got going on at Catawba College with your new video board. And we're looking forward to you being able to use it as well this spring.
Thank you. Appreciate everything that Daktronix has done for us. And another shout out to Corey Williams for making this happen for us. And hopefully he'll be here at one of our first games.
There you go. Well, maybe we'll touch base in a year then, Larry, and see how things are going.
Absolutely.
All right. Thank you.
Thank you. Appreciate it.
Thank you for listening to this episode of the Daktronix Experience Podcast. Please subscribe at your favorite place to listen to podcasts to keep up with our latest episodes.